Bam! My people, my people. It's about that time. If this is your first time tuning in, right. Congratulations, baby. You are now rocking with the best. My name is...
Here we go.
Bam! My people, my people. It's about that time. If this is your first time tuning in, congratulations, baby. You are now rocking with the best. My name is BK, known as the Crypto Trader, and I am the boss of these charts, as you will soon find out. Before we jump into it, I want to go through a few of the new community tools. So without further ado, first up, TradingView. These are all free resources, guys. I do my best to make you money 7 days a week because the markets don't sleep. And this is where I post the charts so you can get a piece of the pie to eat. BDKelly1203, TradingView.com. Check me out on there. I post free charts every time I'm in there just to give you an update and insight on the market. Then you jump over to the number one Bitcoin group in the world, #1Bitcoin on Facebook. Check it out. I'm sure Mark Zuckerberg know me by my first name by now, BK the Boss. Type it in on Facebook. Come on in. The doors are always open. And then when you're ready to put down two and pick up six, jump on over to Patreon where we have different levels. Just type my name right up top, BK Crypto Trader. We got 100+ people holding me down on Patreon. This is the money team. $50 a month for the Cryptopolis Report, $100 for the profit package, and $250 for the boss alert messages, where every other day you get an update from the boss, BK. Bam! It's just that easy to get paid. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for your time. Make sure you like and subscribe right now. Join the money team. The doors are always open. 120 nations and counting. This is the fastest growing crypto community in the world. You are officially a part of history. Now let's go ahead and make this money.
Like a boss.
Huh.
Huh.
Live from the USA, helping you get paid every day. This is the boss of Bitcoin, the Cristo of crypto. It's your boy BK. And if you don't like me, you must not like money. Thank you for joining me, everybody. Got a nice little episode for you called 48.4 million reasons you should buy Bitcoin. Compliments of bossbitcoin.com and yours truly, BK, the crypto trader, also known as the boss of these charts. I am on my laptop right now. I'm on the road, officially in Southern California, about to meet up with some of my teammates who are helping me out to build out the infrastructure we need to accommodate the millions and millions of crypto traders around the world. So, you know, we go hang out a little bit tonight, get to know each other. But until then, I did want to get on and do a quick video for you guys. I saw a news little clip segment that we'll be talking about specifically as it pertains to value and what the CJB bobbleheads still value and why by changing your value, you can change your worth. Most expensive car ever sold at an auction just got sold for 48 million pieces of private banker fiat slave labor debt paper, also known as U.S. dollars, right? Says a Ferrari became the most expensive car ever sold at an auction, right? And this just happened, today, yesterday, sometime in there, right? Keep in mind, I love Ferraris. I'm going to have one myself one day. But I guarantee you, I will not pay $48 million for it. This is what they call
decadence. This is overconsumption at its finest. This is what the end of a civilization looks like insofar as great cycles are concerned, when you can give away $50+ million and yet, you know, change the channel and the bobbleheads on the other channel talk about how broke Americans are and college students can't afford, you know, to buy a house and pay back their loans, and, you know, banks are getting fined and charged and overdraft fees, and, you know, it's one hand literally taking away from the other. And what are they doing with all of the money? Going and paying 50 something million dollars for a Ferrari. Let's check out the video real quick, and then we'll get into who bought it, how they bought it, and more specifically, what that means for you insofar as the blockchain is concerned. So let's check out the video.
Top executive Greg Witten. Now, I asked Witten why anyone would pay so much for a car.
It's very hard to fathom, but, you know, you're in a space where you have collectors and car collectors, and Ferraris are the most collectible car. And this is, the GTO is a pinnacle Ferrari. And it's just an amazing car to have.
A lot of these older, but it's interesting what they call the blue collar collector. We're in a golden age of blue collar, and they love the old Jeeps, the Broncos, the trucks. Lower mileage, the better. So just roll it, go ahead, get it in reverse for a long time. You'll take the mileage off.
Now notice at the end of that, I left that clip in there. That one guy was talking about the golden age. What did I just get done saying? This is the age of decadence. For those of you familiar with rises and falls of great civilizations, often pride cometh before the fall. And pride, when pride is wrapped up and consumed in material possessions consisting of a 1962 Ferrari 250 GTO by another private-owned CJB organization, you know, it's literally money moving around the top of the circle that regular people never see. Let's look up the guy who bought it, my man Greg Witten. I thought the dude was just a little newscaster. The dude that was sitting in front of the car talking, that was the owner. But you can see this dude, you know, is one of the original Microsoft employees. 11th employee of Microsoft. He in there with the little, you know, Beatles picture and all, you know, with Billy G, you know, in his younger days. Just bought a car, $52 million, and that was in 2015. No, his car collection is worth $52 million back in 2015. Well, he just put another $40 on top of that. You know, so he's well over $100 million in cars, right? In cars. In cars. Let that sink in, right? And I was like, how can this dude, you know, regular people, you know, just trying to figure out how next month's rent go get paid, how can this dude drop $100 million and put it on four wheels? And I looked this up. This is a little company right here. Numerix. What do they do? Let's check it out. Look at that guy. Look at that suit. My man, you know what I'm saying? Got his face painted and everything. Looking like Billy Bob Joel the clown and G. Willikers the clown. Call them cousins. Committed to thinking outside the box. Apparently they ain't met me. They haven't heard about Bitcoin. And they damn sure ain't putting none of that $48 million on the blockchain. But they're thinking outside the box. They're the innovators. They take pictures like the Beatles, right? Numerix, established in 1996. CJB Technology Solutions, real-time numbers on a screen. Boom, 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 boom. But this is what I thought the most interesting part was. Numerix is led by G. Willikers, who is the chairman and sole owner of the firm. So this one company, this guy owns outright. All right, go to their Wikipedia page. Revenue, $56 million annually. 400 clients, 25 different countries. And they specialize in risk analysis. And again, all of it is going back to G. Willikers, number 11, from my original Microsoft. But I thought it was ironic that they do risk, quote, risk analysis. And this guy just gave away $48 million for a car that he justified saying was a good car. If anything, that sounds pretty risky to me. And I think for regular broke people like I used to be, that sit in front of the TV and watch the bobbleheads in suits and ties lead you off the edge of a cliff, tell you 15 ways till Friday why you're not getting money, and only one way why you didn't. Only they tell you 15 ways you lost money and not one way how to make money. And they got this clown on here with his risk analysis company telling you, I just bought $44 million Ferrari. But yet, they specialize in risk analysis. That is called a oxymoron. That is called a deception. That is called deceit. And that is also called denial of the fact that we are indeed on the cusp of the greatest transition of wealth in the history of humanity. Just look at them letters right there. Stock session at lows. Literally, in the same sentence, they're saying number 11 just dropped $50 million on a Ferrari. Stock market selling off. So I guess he's just cashing out some of his fake paper money and going and putting four wheels on it. Okay, well, that actually makes sense. Even though I would never put $50 million on four wheels and call it an asset, you know, that's a $50 million liability. But, you know, it ain't tricking if you got it. And, you know, number 11 looked like he got enough of it. So I think in the grand scheme of things, we should just be cognizant of those we seek information from. Again, if one of these guys is wearing a $10,000 suit looking at you, trying to tell you how to make money, then perhaps his best interests aren't aligned with yours. Because quite simply put, you can't afford a $10,000 suit if you haven't already benefited from so many other people along the way, and people are broke. And this is why I tell you every time I get on this internet connection. Right now I'm in a hotel in Southern California about to go meet up with some people and put some software together to change the world, but I'm taking the time today to tell you that these people are literally giving away money. Now keep in mind, when they give it away, they give it right back to each other. You know, they just shaking hands. One hand washed the other, as they say. And I guarantee you, number 11 does not publicly advocate for the blockchain. Because if he did, that $50 million would have went into BTC. And right now, Bitcoin would have probably been about $8,000-$9,000. And this is what I say. This is the opportunity when one person, this one purchase, say number 11, G. Willikers number 11, would have put that $50 million on Bitcoin. What's Bitcoin's current market cap right now? BTC's current market cap, $100 million. Units, thousands. Oh, 100 billion? Is that 100 billion? 100 billion. Units, thousands, millions. So we'd be at like 1 That 5 would be a 6. We'd be about 7,000, 7,200. But you see, they don't do that. He did not do that. What did he do? He went and put it in the same distractive, quote, assets that they've been telling you. And if the CJBs openly walk one way, I am running full speed the opposite. And that in itself is 48.4 million reasons why you should do the same. Bring your money over to the blockchain, where you actually transfer that fiat slave labor debt paper into equity into a global network. And I guarantee you, when the mother CJBs start doing it, you will be handsomely rewarded as a result. That being said, it's that time of the day. Boots, boy BK. No matter where you stay, Brazil to Bay, California, right where I am today, all the way back out through Jerk, my name. Good night, good morning, and good day. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for your time. Give me a thumbs up on this video. It helps everybody else see these videos. You know, let's, people need to start waking up, man. Like the bobbleheads are on TV giving you, quote, information for free 24 hours a day forever. If they could give it to you for free forever, it has no value. Change your values, change your worth. Do that for me if you appreciate mine. Till we meet again, stay cryptic, y'all. Peace.